Right, with that, next up, Jeff Johnson.
Thank you all. Thank you so much. Thank you for being here. Thank you for your leadership of this party. I'm here to ask for your endorsement in 6 months. I will abide by that endorsement. I will enthusiastically support anyone you choose if it's not me, because I think it's important. And thank you for taking this role so seriously. I also want you to thank my beautiful wife, Sonny, who's with me this weekend. Where are you, Sonny? Could you welcome her to the State Central Committee? And then I got to give one more thank you, because I had a van load full of college Republicans from the Twin Cities who got up at 5 a.m. on a Saturday morning to come up and help me. So would you thank them all for being here as well? True confession, I would not have done that when I was in college. So you guys are awesome. I got into this race about 7 months ago for a very singular purpose: to take power away from government and to give it back to the people of Minnesota. The arrogance we have seen from state government lately is absolutely outrageous, and we are going to rein in the DNR and the PCA and the Department of Commerce and every other agency that does not understand its job is not to direct and bully people, it's actually to serve the people who pay their salaries. We are going to aggressively fund roads and bridges, not streetcars and light rail. We are going to respect the rule of law and ban sanctuary cities in the state of Minnesota. We're going to push for a term limit. We're going to make sure work always pays more than welfare in this state. And I am so excited for my very first act as your governor to fire the Met Council and dismantle that beast after all. We have a perfect example of what is the greatest problem in Minnesota, this belief that there are two classes of people, a ruling class and everyone else who needs their help. It will be the first thing I do. And I could go on and on, but instead I want to talk to you about the problem we have here today. Because many of you in this group really, really like multiple candidates. And that's not a surprise, because we have a strong field, as opposed to the car wreck on the DFL side. So they're kind of like the bar seats in Star Wars over there. And if you like multiple candidates, the problem is you only get to pick one in the end. So my job is not just to tell you what I'm going to do, because we all say great things about what we're going to do. My job is to tell you what sets me apart from the other really good Republicans in this race. And for me, it's twofold. Number one, I'm the strongest candidate, most likely to win. And number two, I will be the strongest and boldest governor once elected. So first, I'm winning. I know there are some of you out there who say, Jeff, you ran last time, you lost by 5 points, you don't get a second chance. But I would argue that running in 2014 is actually one of the things that makes me much stronger than any other candidate in 2018. Because I'm the only one who's been through the fire and the extreme betting of a governor's race. Because I'm the only one who has ran against a very popular incumbent and beat him by 10% with independents and tied with independent women. And because, most importantly, because I'm the only one with a positive name ID to not just match, but actually exceed any DFLer that they put up. I will start this race on the 40-yard line. Any other Republican in this race is going to start on the 10 or 20, where I was 4 years ago. Folks, we can win this race. We have to win this race. So we have to pick our strongest candidate. But I have to add to that. We can win this race, we can win this battle, but we can still lose the war. If we don't pick a governor who has the boldness and the background to actually follow through on all these big changes that all of us are talking about. My guess is everyone in this room is just as frustrated as I am with all the Republicans who make big promises and then don't deliver once we get them elected. And you know why that is? I think in many cases, it is because they can talk big, but they lack the fortitude to withstand the onslaught that always comes after from the left, and from the media, and from the bureaucracy, and from the progressives. You all know me, or most of you. You know that I don't run around poking people in the eye for the fun of it. That's not who I am. But you also know that it doesn't bother me a bit to poke people in the eye when they deserve it, and I never shy from a fight. I'm in a minority of one on the Hennepin County Board, so I pick my battles. But when I pick my battles, nobody moves me. And I am used to being called names. I'm used to being ridiculed. I'm used to the hate mail. It comes on a very regular basis. But I can tell you from ample experience that as your governor, they can call me every name in the book. They can call me fascist or hateful or racist or everything else they got. That's not going to make me squirm. That's not going to make me retreat. Because I know what's right, because I'm very confident in who I am, and because I know I have the love of Jesus in my heart for every soul in this state, regardless of their race, or their religion, or their politics. And they can demonize me as something other than that. But I won't apologize, and I won't shift my position. Instead, I'm going to say, slander all you want, you're wrong, but get the hell out of my way, because I have work to do for the people of Minnesota. Minnesota is doing so much better than what they've got the last 7 years. And the awesome thing is, we can give it to them. If we choose our strongest candidate, and if we pick a governor who has the confidence and the boldness to actually follow through. Together, folks, we can give the government of Minnesota back to the people of Minnesota, and we will turn this state bright red. Thank you for all you do. And I hope you enjoy.